Welcome back to the Buck Stops Here. Now to a rather intriguing controversy. The Mumbai police have arrested a security... called Hari Prasad. Hari Prasad hit the headlines for questioning the fairness of electronic... Welcome back to the Buck Stops Here. Now to a rather intriguing controversy. The Mumbai police have arrested a security analyst called Hari Prasad. Hari Prasad hit the headlines for questioning the fairness of electronic voting machines, something that was proven by the Election Commission to be completely false. Now the Mumbai police say that Mr. Hari Prasad is responsible for the theft of an EVM.
Hari Prasad, a leading electronic security expert from Hyderabad, under arrest. The police say he stole an electronic voting machine from the Mumbai collector's office. Charges denied by Hari Prasad's colleagues from overseas. They say they were researching whether Indian EVMs are tamper-proof. And a source had offered them the voting machine to study. Hari Prasad's co-researcher says it appears to be a politically motivated attempt to uncover an anonymous source. The arresting officers told Hari that they were under pressure from the top and he would be left alone if he would reveal the source's identity.
Why did you arrest the civil society activist? This is against the ethics of the election. Who is involved in this? The question is, who is behind this?
Prasad, along with a computer scientist at the University of Michigan and a Dutch technology activist, had presented a paper showing how EVMs can be tampered. The research soon hit the blog world and was endorsed by Edward W. Felton of Princeton University, who said, "The chair of the Electoral Commission has called the machines infallible. I hope the new study will cause the EC to take a more realistic approach." Around the same time, Hari Prasad appeared on a show on TV9's Telugu channel where he demonstrated how an EVM can be hacked. 4 months later, the Mumbai police say that the EVM on the show is the same piece that had gone missing from the Mumbai collector's office. The charges against Hari Prasad, theft and break-in.
Based on the evidences collected, he was summoned for investigation, and subsequently, based on the evidence, he has been arrested on 21st of this month.
What seems bizarre, Hari Prasad's research was concluded in April, but the EVM was reported missing only in May. Now, with international faces coming to Hari Prasad's defense and allegations of human rights violation being leveled, the police will be under pressure to prove that they have a watertight case. In Mumbai, Rashmi Rajput for NDTV.
Ironically, the arrest of Hari Prasad may have reopened what was considered a dead issue, whether electronic voting machines can be tampered with. Let's get straight into our panel. I want to start with Mr. Mehndi Ratha, representing the Election Commission. Mr. Mehndi Ratha, the EC had actually dared anybody to come and prove
We still stand by that offer because we made an open offer. We heard something that the machines can be tampered with. So we said, okay, if you have any problem, you come and show before the election finishes.
And were there any takers for that challenge? Did people come?
Some people came, including Mr. Hari Prasad. He came with Mr. V.V. Rao. We just saw him on the TV. Yes. He came and then they said they can do it something. Then we said, okay, you do. And we offered them 100 machines which we had brought from 10 different states. And at random we had just brought, we had put them in our office. We said, you choose any machine of your liking, then you show us how it can be hacked or how it can be tampered with. Then they said, we want some time. We said, okay, you take any amount of time. But only condition is, you will not be allowed to take the machine out of the office. You sit here for any number of days. Day, night, you sit, we have no problem. We also sit with you. You do whatever you want. You show us how the machine can be tampered with.
And then?
So, then of course they said we want some more time, and then they went, and then there was another meeting. Even on the 10th August, only about 12 days back, and Mr. Hari Prasad and V.V. Rao, they all came. And we had another round of discussion. Then they openly said that we are not opposed to this EVM system. There may be some technical or some administrative procedures which you need to tighten. we can come out with some administrative and some other...
So they gave you that assurance?
Yeah, that assurance. And we said, okay, you give us those constructive ideas, some suggestions. We are prepared. We have an absolutely open mind. We are prepared to discuss with you. We are prepared to sit with you. And then they said, okay, we'll give you. And then we decided that at some mutual convenient date, we'll again meet. And one thing more, I because these people are saying that about this this arrest.
Yes.
I would just like to say, see, on the one hand, they were in negotiations with us, or rather they were in dialogue with us.
Yes.
Then we also offered, as I said, 100 machines, you can see. Then on the 28th April or 29th April, on some TV channel, one EVM was shown, and that was shown by Mr. Hari Prasad. And Mr. Hari Prasad on that TV show itself said that I have got it through some unauthorized sources.
Let me take this to Mr. Rao. You've made a number of interesting points. Mr. Rao, we all remember that dare by the Election Commission. You went along with Hari Prasad. You couldn't prove anything. Now it turns out that this EVM that was being demonstrated on TV9 was actually a stolen EVM. Now, isn't, whatever be the principle, isn't there a problem with theft?
Let me first clarify, Barkha. The Election Commission of India has been giving out misleading statements and has been spreading untruthful information to somehow sell their arguments, which are completely untenable. First of all, this is a complete fallacy that they had given an opportunity to hack the machines in their premises without any conditions. In fact, we went there on September 3rd last year. They stopped us from hacking the machine. In fact, we have given them an open challenge, and I am willing to take this on record today. If Election Commission wants us to show how this is to be done, let Hari Prasad come out of jail. As it will be shown in the presence of media. Are they willing to take a challenge how this has been done?
But can I first ask you, did Mr. Hari Prasad steal this machine?
I think that's absurd. How can,
how did he get
first
it,
of all,
then?
They don't know.
How
no,
did
that's
he get
absurd.
It?
Somebody from the Mumbai, one of their insiders gave access to the machine. The machine was taken to Hyderabad and given to Hari Prasad for conducting this activity, and it was returned thereafter. The question is, Election Commission of India does not know a machine went missing from their own godown for 2 months until it was shown on television by Hari Prasad. And even after that, they take 15 days to find out where this machine came from.
Now, Mr. Rao, I want to ask you, an EVM is not connected to an external technology in the sense that it's not linked to the internet, for example. So this word hacking is a very strange word to use in the context of the EVM, because it's not actually connected to another system at all whereby somebody can control it by a remote control.
Barkha, you see, neither you nor I are the best judges of it. Last week, we were in Washington, D.C. I appeared on a panel discussion along with Election Commission representatives. Professor Indiresan was there formally. They came with the same kind of arguments before an expert group of security researchers from all over the world, primarily from the U.S., Canada and Europe. And they came out with a statement, which is a public document. And in this statement, they said, your arguments are untenable. This is the professors of computer science from Harvard, Stanford, California, and all over the US and Canada and Germany.
Okay. Let me understand technology far better than what me, you, or Mr. Mendiratta understand. No, I'm sure. But hacking by definition, in my understanding, is getting into a machine through some other machine.
Yes. Mr. Mendiratta. Actually, our machines are standalone machines. Yes, every police station has a separate machine. It's not connected to any other source. So
all these arguments are fine.
I would like to remind Mr. Narasimha Rao, you're both speaking together.
Mr. Mendiratta, quickly you and then Mr. Rao.
So what I want to tell Mr. Narasimha Rao, then why we say this Stanford University or that word, are we not proud of our own people? Have we any dearth of our own experts who are so brilliant in this field of technology? Why should we say because England has done something or Germany has done something, so why should they not follow us?
Okay, quick last two comments from both of you. Mr. Rao, I'm wrapping up the show, 10 seconds. Where does this debate go from here?
No, I think what we need to understand is throughout the world, paperless voting is something that is an anathema. You cannot have voting without a paper record, because when you go to an ATM, you want a slip that you have done a transaction. When you do a property purchase, you want a record.
But isn't it easy? Weren't elections rigged in India in the age of paper voting as well? Yeah. There were famous boot captures, rigging of elections.
No, but at least you know that this has happened. But with electronic voting, you don't even know whether rigging has happened.
Okay.
You are completely blind. We are completely non-transparent system.
Okay.
So what we are trying to seek is move towards a verifiable voting system where you have a record of voting.
Okay. Mr. Rao, that's a different argument. You're saying a verifiable voting system.
Yes,
very quickly, sir. Last word.
See, in our voting machines, there is a system where every vote is recorded. Produce the results before the courts, where supposing they want to know for whom I have voted, at what point of time I have voted. All that record is there.
Will you accept Mr. Rao's new challenge?
No, I won't. Yeah.
We are
ready for Hari Prasad.
We have given him time.
Mr. Rao, let me end with saying that S.K. Mehndiratta is saying Hari Prasad can come and prove him right or wrong. Let's end.
I have to do this in the presence of the media.
Okay, presence of the media. We'll do it on this show. We will call Hari Prasad and S.K. Mehndiratta, and you on this show, we'll have to end it there. Mr. Rao, Mr. Mehndiratta, we'll have to end it there.
Sure,
okay, we welcome it. We'll see the testing of the EVMs on the buck stops here. We'll call it a day now. It's the close of the buck stops here tonight. We'll see you tomorrow night at 10 p.m. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.